Here we go. Maybe this makes a little more sense now. As things get closer, I'm doing this step down, and I'll put the next brick block in here, and it'll be, you know, overlapping this block that's stepped down. And I just had a, you know, this string line I got here is level right with the top of those blocks, and all the way down the hill for this course. Every course is different, you know, far as straight edge and level, because you're going up and down, and each block, each row is further in towards the hill or further away from the hill if you're going down. So anyway, that's your step down. This thing's a little out of level, but I got it filled with rock, and I'll kind of level it out. But this next brick, if you look here, next block will be right there shooting. That bottom row will be right in the middle of it, which it's supposed to be, so you have proper overlap. And it's lower, one course lower, so it'll be 1 inch further away from the hill. Need to think about that, because up in there I wasn't thinking about it. Things kept going in and out on me, and I finally dawned on me what I was doing wrong. But anyway, big bed of rock, 10 ton of rock there, 10 ton of rock, larger rock here, drain tile on a nice big bed of rock underneath around the front. We want everything to drain real well. I'll do videos on that when I start doing the, you know, the cloth material that goes back up the hill to keep, help hold this wall from caving off. You know, it's going to be 6 to 7, 8 feet tall down at the lower end. So we'll have that mesh gridlock, geo grid they call it, that'll every third course. So I'll start doing some of that once I get further down the hill, you know. But anyway, it's nice having that string there, because I can measure down, you know, and I know exactly where I need to be, because it's level and has a line level on it down there. Helps out quite a bit.